Anyway, some of my cameras run. The last video I recorded was actually after this story. I forgot to write this story on the list of things I wanted to talk about. But this is taking place in Springville, Utah. We grew up, this is prior to being elementary school age. I was a stay-at-home kid with a stay-at-home mom. Whew, speeding up, sorry. Sorry, Pappy. I remember we had one of those big old generic awnings someone had made out of 2x4s and fiberglass, wavy sheets, hanging off the front of our house. Now, our house was built in like 1906 or something like that. I'll have to find out for sure. But it was back, the first picture of it had a carriage out front, not a house for about 30 miles. No, I don't know how many houses were there, but I remember seeing the picture. I'll see if I can find that original picture. It's probably gone and obsolete, but I'm sure it might be around here somewhere too. Anyway, so we decided to tear that old bugger off because we thought that was the ugliest thing on such a pretty house. So we did. We tore it off. And we had stacked all the 2x4s all neatly on the end of the porch so they could be, you know, denailed and reused for another purpose, you know, trying to be all thrifty-like. And, one day, I remember there was some fellow over visiting my dad. I don't remember who or why or what or where or when, why, how, you know, any of that. I just remember he was out there visiting. I wanted to be with my daddy. So I was out on the front porch. I thought, you know, those 2x4s look like good balancing beams. I'm going to see if I can balance on them. And I remember my pappy, he says, dude, you shouldn't be doing that. You're going to step on a nail. Bet you can't guess what happened next. I stepped on a nail. And I was wearing, back in them times, I thought them penny loafer shoes were quite the thing. You know, they were pretty stock because you could stick a penny inside them. And I never had a penny put in them, but I had penny loafers, nonetheless. Whew. I said 50, I'm going into the 70. I probably should pay attention to what I'm doing too, huh? That's not too bad. Nice little windy twisty here. Anyway, that nail, I remember when I stepped on the nail, I looked down, and that nail was coming out the top of the shoe. And I remember that hurt. That hurt quite a bit. And I debate what hurt worse, though. Because I'd stepped on a nail, I then had to turn around and get stabbed with a shot to get the tetanus shot. So it's like, hey, not only did you screw up once, but we're going to make sure you remember what it felt like a little later. So you get stabbed in the foot, we're going to stab you in the shoulder. How does that sound? Anyway, there you go. There is probably the first story that I can recall of me being injured. Now, sure, I've had many more injuries that I don't recall. And maybe my mammy and my pappy will have to tell them stories someday if I never get them on camera. But, yeah, so there you go. There's story number one taking place in story number two's position. And we'll go on to story number three here in just a moment.